I'm reefing with y'all like y'all reefing with me. Now let's jump to the video y'all came to see.
Hey guys, I'm back on YouTube again. Just following through. If you guys have not seen the first episode of the dream build, this is the dream tank that I always wish I had, and now I'm actually doing it. So this is the Modular Marine Return Overflow that I had got. I believe that it is going to work out well, and I also had to drill in his tank two return holes. One on the right and one on the left next to the Modular Marine Overflow. So guys, I'm going to show you guys how to remove the two back weirs out of this 120-gallon marine tank. And I had to cut out the silicone with the razor blade. So I then, in turn, decided to take the razor blade and slowly but surely drag it up the silicone, cutting out the silicone behind the weir. Just taking it and putting some pressure on the razor blade, dragging it along the glass to cut out this overflow weir. Here I show you a demonstration on how I had did this and accomplished to taking out these weirs. I am just dragging the razor blade up the glass in order to get the silicone from behind the weir. And then after a little bit, I decide to wiggle the weir to show you that it is coming off of the wall. These weirs were definitely siliconed into this tank pretty good and held in as long as they did. The reason why I am removing these weirs is because I believe that there is detritus trapped inside of the weir that keeps making the nitrate levels and becoming a nitrate factory. It is now loose, and as I wiggle it, I am starting to think, hey, this may be a little harder than I thought that it would be to cut this thing out of here. I have done this once before, cut out glass and cut out the silicone, and I have used a guitar wire before. I think it was either the G string or the K string, but then after that, I felt that the other side was loose enough that I can start on this side of the weir box. I used the same routine, just dragged the razor blade up the glass and cut the weir box out. I am sorry that this video isn't more entertaining. I know taking these weirs out of this tank was not the most funnest project that I have done, and I kind of started to get a little bit irritated because the weir box was not coming out right away as easy as I thought. I continue to cut on both sides of the weir box and kept wiggling to see if it was loose enough for me to get it out. This silicone isn't like normal silicone. This is like some marine grade or something that is more tough, and it is also kind of like a plastic film. I started to get more irritated and decided that since it was not coming out with the razor blade because I could not get to the other side, I decided to use a cutting wheel to cut the weir box down the middle in order to wiggle it out more. So I went and got the cutting wheel, and I had spoke to one of my friends and asked him if I should release the part of the video where I am cutting it out with the cutting wheel, and he told me I should not. So I did not release that part of the video. Some of you guys who can accomplish this task will understand how to use a cutting wheel and be able to cut it out with the cutting wheel. But sorry, I could not put that in this video. So I then used this razor blade in order to scrape off all of the silicone off of the tank and off of the bottom of the tank. I then proceeded to just scrape it off of the bottom of the tank, just like I am doing here, and also trying to make sure that it's completely clear of the silicone. Because what I think I'm going to eventually do
is cover these holes up with another piece of glass and silicone the glass down to these holes. The reason why I am doing this is because I installed the modular marine overflow into the side of the tank to make this a peninsula style tank instead of just a normal 120 gallon marine tank. For those of you who are my main subscribers and have been giving me thumbs ups, thanks a lot, and I strongly appreciate you guys' support. In this video, I show you how to remove the weirs out of this 120 gallon tank. Also, I will be showing a little bit about cycling live rock and how I did cycle the live rock for this tank, and also on my lighting. I give a short snippet at the end of my lighting that is going to be demonstrated in my next video for the update. Now that I have removed all of the silicone on the bottom of the tank for both of these weir boxes, I then shaved off all of the silicone on the side of the tank. So I am almost finished with this project of removing the weirs out of this tank. Wow. I cannot believe all of the detritus and sand that was stuck in the bottom of the weir overflows. Here is a couple images of the pictures that I took of the detritus and buildup that was inside those overflows. Now I will talk about live rock and how I cycled my live rock for this tank. I put a bucket outside with a pump and PVC flowing up through the center of it with water. I also bleached this live rock to remove all of the detritus, pests, creatures, animals, bacteria, everything that was on it that is undesirable to the new reef system that I'm going to be putting up. I made sure that I put a lid on this brute container to reduce the evaporation, causing it to drive the salinity levels up. That would be causing it to drive the salinity levels up. So this is about 2 weeks of the live rock cycling. It is starting to have the water clear up, but as you can tell, there's a lot of detritus and stuff in the water. Here is the live rock. Once it's done cycling, I let it cycle for a month. The nitrate was reading kind of high, but it had zero nitrate, zero phosphate. So this rock is finally done with cycling for me to aquascape it and be able to glue it in this build that I will go over with in my next update, along with the lighting. This tank will have a hybrid of lighting, LEDs, metal highlights, and T5s. Make sure to tune in for my next update. Make sure you subscribe, thumbs up, and give me a comment if you either like what you're seeing or you have questions about this reef build. Thanks a lot, guys, and I'll see you on the next video. My next update should be about the Rescue Zoa tank. Stay tuned for more.